This is question number 12. This question is on vectors. In this particular problem, A and B are two unit vectors which are mutually perpendicular to each other, and then there is a vector C given which is of the form xA plus yB plus A cross B, and vector C is given to be inclined at an angle of alpha with both vectors A and vector B, and we are then asked to find the value of 8 cos squared alpha. Again, this is an easy problem. We start with vector C and we try to find x and y. Now that can be easily done by taking the dot product of this particular vector equation with vector A and vector B. So if I take the dot product with A cross B dot A is going to vanish, B dot A is going to vanish, and here we'll be having A dot A, which is 1. So we are having x here, and here we'll be having C dot A. Modulus of C is known to us to be 2. So therefore the dot product value is going to be 2 cos alpha, as the angle between C and A is alpha. So the value of x is 2 cos alpha. In the similar manner, if I will take the dot of this particular equation with vector B, I will be having C dot B equals to y, rest all will vanish because of perpendicularity, and y will be equal to 2 cos alpha. Apart from that, we can use the fact that modulus C is equal to 2. For that, first let us find out the magnitude of A cross B, which is obviously going to be 1 because they are orthogonal vectors. Mod A mod B sin theta, and theta was given to be equal to 90 degree obviously, because A dot B is 0. So we have got modulus A cross B to be 1, and now we can just take the modulus square for this thing, which is going to be x square plus y square plus modulus A cross B whole squared, which is going to be 1. Rest all the dot products are obviously 0 because the three vectors are orthogonal, and therefore mod C square is 4. This is 4 cos square alpha plus 4 cos square alpha plus 1, which gives us 8 cos square alpha equal to 3, and this is what precisely they have asked, the value of 8 cos square alpha, and this, therefore the answer is going to be 3. In paper 1 question number 13, A, B, C are real numbers excluding 0, and we are given a trigonometric equation root 3 a cos x plus 2 b sin x equal to c, and the value of x belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Alpha plus beta is given to be pi by 3, and we are asked the value of b by a. So since alpha is the solution of this equation, we can start by putting alpha into this equation, and we get root 3 a cos alpha plus 2 b sin alpha equals to c. In the similar manner, beta is the root of this equation, so we can substitute the value of beta here, and we get root 3 a cos beta plus 2 b sin beta equal to c, and we can then subtract the two equation to get rid of c. So we have got root 3 a cos alpha minus cos beta plus 2 b times sin alpha minus sin beta equals to 0, and we can just apply cos c minus cos d here and sin c minus sin d here. So we are having 2 b sin alpha minus beta by 2 into cos alpha plus beta by 2 equals to root 3 a sin alpha plus beta by 2 into sin, actually beta minus alpha by 2, but that minus will be negated as we have taken the term over there, and therefore it results to us in 2 b by a equals to root 3 times tan alpha plus beta by 2. Now the value of alpha plus beta is given to be pi by 3, so that is tan pi by 6, which is 1 by root 3. So value of b by a comes out to be half, and that is 0.5. So the answer to this question must be 0.5.